Hey, what's up, guys? Sean back with another video and girl world. Boy, is this a depressing place to be, but some of y'all love this stuff. I don't know why, but Amberlyn Reed, Big Foodie Beauty, and what's her name? Hungry Fat Chick, the chick we're doing a video on today. But I guess she's losing weight? I don't know. I haven't seen this, but she lost how much weight? I'm not sure. So, I just want to see it, and if she's doing good, I kind of want to give her flowers, because she deserves it. I mean, the last thing I saw about her, I'm pretty sure she was on Death's Door. So, yeah, I'm kind of interested to see if that was kind of like the wake-up call she needed. And if it was, sometimes it takes something like that. But, let's just check it out.
My bowels had a sweet release. I could feel it everywhere. I had crapped my pants.
Oh, God.
Prison. She needs prison.
I kind of have OCD.
You mean OBCD?
Was that your bones?
Yes.
I've been grown. I pay my bills. My bills are paid.
Oh, by the way, I love Apathetic Facts channel. This is the only reason I know about Girl World. Them and Dainty, I think, are the two I used to watch. Whenever you guys ask. But this is all I know.
Hey, girls. So today we are covering Hungry Fat Chick, a.k.a. Candy Godiva. Candy is an American YouTuber who has built her following.
Is her name really Godiva? Well, no freaking wonder she's fat. She's named after chocolate. What the hell did you expect?
Going around her massive mukbangs and adult feeder content. But unlike Amberlyn Reed or Chantal, aka Foodie Beauty, Candy has a good relationship with her audience and is generally well liked.
Oh my god. All of her videos are over 1 million. I didn't know that many guys were getting off to cheese pools, man. This is crazy. The feeder universe never ceases to amaze me.
Overall, the majority of the commenters on the channel are nice, kind people. And I appreciate you all very, very much.
Recently, after a hospitalization due to cellulitis in her stomach and a sharp decline in her health, she has chosen to try the carnivore diet for 30 days.
Eggs. Oh, so you can have cheese on that diet? Okay, so I guess what I was doing before wasn't keto, because I was just eating meat and cheese. It said dairy products.
Hey, y'all. No long video going up today in the hospital. Just an infection. I should be home in a few days. But talk later. Bye.
After the hospital stay, she noted a major lack of energy to even do mukbangs, let alone get up to microwave food, which made her realize she wants to try to get healthy.
I'm really not feeling like doing a mukbang today. I'm just not.
Is it mukbang or mukbang? Because isn't it spelled with an A? But also, when was she microwaving shit anyway? All I ever saw was DoorDash when I watched this.
At some point in the evening, I will order food.
Told you.
I don't want to go cook. Anyway, I may do a video of the mukbang later tonight. I may not. Probably not. Because I've been ordering food like a mad person since I got out. You know, and I don't even want to heat stuff up in the microwave. I mean, and it's not that I'm lazy. It's just the easier for me, the better, you know.
Is heating stuff up in the microwave hard? I mean, I lived on microwave stuff for a while. Don't get me wrong, that's a life of a bachelor, but whenever I'm by myself, shit, I microwave some stuff. I ain't gonna lie.
Walking to the door from this chair has been the easiest thing, you know?
So today we are going to be taking a look at her 30-day weight loss journey on the carnivore diet, and did it work for her?
I'm hoping.
Hey, y'all.
Also, what's that tattoo? Is that like a bite out of a donut? I don't know what the hell. Is that a crab claw? You're really into this mukbang life if you get a crab claw. But seafood's good, man.
Yep. No eating video today again. I've got a lot going on in my mind right now. What's going on is something that's been on my mind for a really long time now. And I know y'all probably feel it or felt it coming. I'm not quitting mukbangs, I'm not gonna say.
Hell no, that's the cash cow. You know what 1 million views is worth? While you're sitting there, like, having a cheese pull? And could you imagine the money this chick makes? Like, damn, that's big bread. Shit, I'd probably eat myself into the grave for that kind of stuff.
Quitting mukbangs, no. The direction of my channel, if things go the way that I'm planning,
I'm kidding,
by the
way,
to change drastically. You know, I have issues with the word diet. Basically, what I'm going to be doing is, for all intents and purposes, a diet. Basically...
I mean, what's wrong with a diet? I know the fat acceptance movement's kind of like, diet is a hate word, blah, but... I mean, really? It's not that damn bad. It just means you're restricting calories or doing something. I've been on one of them suckers for so long, I forgot what it's like to eat normal. Well, actually, I never knew what it was like. Well, you know.
I am an addict. I'm addicted to sugar. I'm addicted to fast food. I'm addicted to carbs, bread, potatoes, rice. The panic comes in where I'm obviously afraid of failure. I know myself, and I know I have no freaking willpower.
Look, if you're afraid of failure, you're never going to succeed, and I would say that you're defined by how many times you fall down and get back up.
But I want you guys to know that I'm actually really, really excited about this. Carnivore.
Good.
Carnivore, okay? Basically, carnivore is meat. Meat and animal products. The only animal product that's not really considered carnivore is like honey. Just, Lord...
That's sugar. That's nature's sugar. What? If somebody, like, tripped and they thought, man, this is made by animals, it's good. They're really going to F up their self because they're going to gain so much weight.
Help me, can I lose 200 pounds so I can get a hip if I need one? Because I kind of think I'm getting to the point where I'm going to need a hip, so.
Somebody blew out her hip after that.
I have to change. It's time. It's truly... truly time that I change the game. I mean, okay, there's the scale. Yep, the last time I weighed in, it was a lot more than I had thought it was.
Yeah, them damn scale gremlins, they'll get you every time.
I was 452.8.
Hello. Pounds, please.
It's ready.
Okay, zero. Oof. Can't see. Shoot. Be still.
What fat guys see when they look for their wiener.
1.2 pounds. Holy crap.
Goodbye.
Yeah, goodbye. I wanted to give you a peek inside my pantry. All clear.
I thought she weighed way more than that, the way she's wheezing. Honestly, she's not in that bad a shape as far as, like, comparing to myself. I would have friggin' been happy as hell to see that number at the start.
We're starting out okay. I got 2 bags worth of stuff from Sprouts, 18 eggs, I got the Angus grass-fed boneless chuck steak. That's nice and fatty.
You get the good shit when you get them mukbang views, baby.
Yeah, that's what we're looking for.
Mukbang comes in.
On the carnivore. Well, that's a tiny one. Okay, and I know it's not carnivore. I got the organic spicy brown, uncured applewood.
If you're doing keto though, mustard doesn't have carbs, so I would put that stuff on a lot.
Good bacon. That's another nice size chuck steak. That's all I got was chuck steaks. And is 85% lean, 15% fat, grass fed. We are on a carnivore journey.
Bro, she's eating good. Shit, I wasn't buying that expensive ground beef. I was getting the giant meat tube things that they had at fucking Walmart. Sorry, I try not to cuss, man.
But anyway, this is my groceries for the week, pretty much. Oh, and as you noticed, I didn't get any cheese. I just worry. I mean, I don't want to do too much dairy, like right in the...
Is that a crab claw or a horny mermaid? I can't figure it out. I see a woman humping a sea clam. I don't know what that is.
The beginning. I'm going to be getting all my dairy from butter. You know, animal fats is what I'm going for with this diet. But yeah, so I've already lost a few pounds. just water weight. It's just the water weight coming off right now, I'm sure. This is about subtracting.
Look, we take them water weight pounds, sweetie. When you get up in that high, it still counts.
Subtracting anything that comes with carbs, you know. And I know carbs aren't necessarily bad for you, but
They're the devil.
Right now, I want to burn fat. I want to burn fat, and I want to reduce inflammation, so I need to stay away from carbs and anything that makes sugar. But I'm starting out as strong as I can, and hopefully I can keep it up. I say hopefully, but right now I'm really, really confident that I've got this. I just woke up feeling one day that this is what I need to do, and I've danced around it for way too long.
That's the right mindset. If you start out with that, you know, I'm in it to win it type attitude, then you can't fail. Like, you got the mindset. There's a switch, man. And even when I started the weight loss surgery, I didn't have it flipped yet. I wasn't ready. But once you're there where she is, I think this is going to be a great success, to be honest.
It was just time. So here I am, you know, wholeheartedly trying.
She did lose some weight due to being in the hospital, but it did jumpstart this new way of life for her, and she's starting off really strong.
After 7 days doing the meat-only thing, my energy is actually up a little bit. I haven't had any headaches.
Bro, it's crazy to see what makeup can do again, man. I'm joining the beauty community after this. Bye, guys. I'll see ya. I'll be a...
And I actually haven't even had any heartburn in almost all week. Shoot, I mean, I've actually felt really good. For most of the time, I've got a smile on my face most of the time. You know, I'm thinking positive thoughts, you know, very hopeful thoughts, you know, and I'm seeing the goal. I'm seeing the end goal.
That's good. If you beat yourself up all the time, then, like, you're never going to think positively. She's got the right mindset. I actually like her. I think she's a likable person.
According to the scale today, I'm definitely on the right track. You know, and I don't expect this pace to keep up. I really don't. I ain't saying that I cheated, because I didn't cheat. But I went for fast food last night.
Son, I just said she was on the... What the hell, Candy? Oh my God. Me looking stupid again.
Right, because yesterday I did not eat enough. But anyway, I'm 7 days in, and I'm already feeling better. I think my double chin is kind of... Is it shrinking just a little? I can't tell.
Bro, that's what I'm saying. You measure your weight in funny ways when you get that big. Like, is there that much jiggle in my thigh today? I must have lost a few pounds, baby.
And even if I end up getting a little bit of fast food, I'm doing my damnedest not to order off of carnivore.
Get like a Power Bowl at Taco Bell. That's not that bad.
Here's
take the beans out.
Here's my first meal of the day. I cooked up a couple of the grass-fed burger patties. Got me a chicken today. Whole rotisserie chicken.
Those rotisserie chickens are good as hell. You can get them for like $6 at Costco or Sam's. But the burgers she cooked, I don't know why they were that color. Maybe she's just got better beef than me or something. That shit looked like salmon.
It's a little bit charred, but it's still going to be good. I also got some things for snacks. I got the sardines. And I got some pre-boiled eggs. I mean, I've got eggs I can boil, but... And some smoked oysters. And here's my steak. Here's my other meal of the day. Today is Monday. From Sunday, I had rotisserie chicken on Sunday, and I ate all the dark meat and all the skin and all the fat and all that stuff, and just had breasts left. So I'm...
Bro, tell me, are you guys dark meat or white meat? Because I'm going to go straight for the thighs every time. Thick thighs save lives, you know?
Mixed in some seasoning and 3 tablespoons of soft butter. This is what I ordered today.
Butter chicken. Sorry, I'm pausing a lot. Butter chicken? Ew.
I got a crispy pata from Goldilocks. And they do include sauces that I don't think I can have. Look at that crispy, fatty, juicy pork.
If you're doing carnivore, can you still have like the fried pork like that? Because, I mean, it's technically meat, but what? No, is that just skin that's fried though? It's not breaded, right?
Deliciousness. And this is so much like meat and fat and... goodness that it will last me all day today and probably first meal tomorrow. I'm doing great. I mean, I feel like I'm really onto something here. So far, carnivore's doing me good. I'm enjoying it.
Good.
And I'll be honest though, I'm kind of looking forward to going a little more ketovore. I haven't incorporated a lot of vegetable anything other than like pepper and a few little herbs and whatnot.
Yeah, I guess what I was doing was carnivore. I always tell you guys keto, but I was just eating meat and cheese, really. but I didn't know keto. I thought vegetables had carbs. I was staying under 10 carbs a day. That was my goal.
All right, there it is. The scale, the mighty, mighty scale.
It's ready.
It's ready, okay. Oh, okay. Hand in.
428.6 pounds.
Really?
Oh, shit. Shoot,
it's Wednesday. That's what it is.
Isn't that what? She's losing weight, though. She's doing good. But boil your own damn eggs. You can't be that lazy. Although she does. Is she a smoker? Because she wheezes a lot.
It is Wednesday the 28th. I've already eaten about half of the pork that was there. It was from a crispy pata yesterday. I ate about half of it already. And I've got 6 eggs to eat for the rest of the evening. Here's my food for the day. It's Thursday, in week 2 of carnivore. Tomorrow's Friday.
Bruh, look, on carnivore, you can still eat pretty good. I'd say turkey bacon, but I'm not gonna lie and act like I didn't eat regular-ass bacon sometimes. Turkey bacon's better, though.
That would be day 14. 40. Hey, y'all. Today is Friday, July 7th, 419.4, I think was the final weight. This is 21 days on carnivore. And this last week this is the best week yet, okay? Absolutely no takeout, not even on the first day of the week.
Wow, so she's gotten the roll, right? That's that switch flip like I'm talking about. But once you start seeing progress like that, it's hard just to say, like, I don't have willpower, because obviously she does. Like, if she wants it bad enough, she's got it.
And that's an accomplishment. This is the longest I've gone without ordering takeout since I've lived in this new apartment. It's going pretty good. I'm not having random cravings. I'm not browsing the Uber Eats and the DoorDash anymore.
Do you guys browse Uber Eats like that? Like, I'm like that on Amazon. I'm an Amazon addict, man. That shit's bad.
But, as y'all can tell, I'm really enjoying myself on the carnivore diet since I started carnivore. No digestive issues. God, there's just been so many, like, positive changes. I'm kind of at this crossroads thing with my channel, where this is what I'm doing right now as far as food.
Where she's losing Patreons because guys are like, she's losing weight. No. I guess the horny feeders. I don't know.
Goes. And food for many, many, many years has been my focus in life. And obviously it's still going to be a focus for a little while, you know, but I don't want it to be the focus. I want, once I've educated myself enough, or created good habits of, you know, getting up, getting what I need to start my day.
Look, she started the good habits. I'd say nobody knows how to do it right out the gate, especially if you've just spent your whole life eating whatever you want, right? Like, I know that. She knows that. But she's doing the right thing. She's sitting there. She's being strict. That's why I think that's a great diet, because it's pretty strict, right? So you can't give yourself leeway.
Fasting till like 2-3 o'clock in the afternoon, then I'm definitely good, you know, for one meal a day. This past week, I've pretty much been doing one meal a day. I was over 450, put it that way. 452.8 is what the scale said the first day. And then a couple of days later, I weighed myself and I think I was down to 441 point something. So
it's kind of crazy how quick it melts off with that diet. I'd say if you're this big or as big as I was, 3 or 4 pounds a day at the start is like totally possible.
Oh, it's like I started dropping weight immediately and it was like water just. So then 433 and 428.6 and then today, so. Yeah, it's already been a journey. It's already been a journey. I tell you what, 3 weeks in, my inflammation is down so much. I eventually want to go keto. I want to inch my way into keto by adding a few vegetables in here and there.
Yeah, she could do that, but I'd argue that she's doing so well at this point, why switch things up? Like, you know what you have to do with this diet, but hey, only she knows.
I don't know, I just feel good right now. And I'm thankful, you know, I'm thankful that I did this for myself.
Good. It's the right attitude, guys.
So, day 28.
Holy shit, the makeup's gone. That's crazy, man. We just went from like, oh, damn, she looks pretty good, to... what is this? The Walking Dead? Like, her eyes, she got crazy bags under her eyes. I like her. I'm just emphasizing the difference, man. It's crazy.
Eight, carnivore. Week 4 was a rough one for me. It was really rough. Definitely, you know, went off the wagon. Three different times this past week. At least
three times. The damn wheel fall off the sucker if you did it three times.
I kind of stayed with the program, but still, you know, probably wasn't the best, you know, choice. That one time I went full binge mode.
Full Krispy Kreme demon, baby.
And it did me no favors. Did me no favors. I felt like crap. It was not worth it. And I'm not recovered from that binge yet. But that's not the worst of it. You know, the little...
You guys want to know something funny? The first time somebody asked me if I had ED, I was like, why are they asking if I have erectile dysfunction? I didn't even know. I was like, my shit works. I'm not that old.
The weight gain isn't the worst of it. And obviously, the weight gain is probably fluid, you know, water retention because of the inflammation. Not smart. Not smart. I was just getting to a place where I was actually starting to feel pretty good. So I'm still working on my 30 days carnivore. I've got 2 days left.
We'll call it 26.
On the full carnivore. And then I think I'm gonna kind of relax that strict. I think a low carb, a meat focused, low carb meat focused. I'm looking at things like Brussels sprouts and asparagus and broccoli, and I'm like, I'm craving green things. I
would get that. Me, I never eat vegetables anyway, so it didn't friggin' matter.
I don't know why. Where I screwed up this past week was I did not buy my groceries like I wanted to buy my groceries, so I didn't have things handy. A setback is just a setback, basically.
True.
And it just motivates me to get right back on the horse. You know, and I'm...
lay off the horses, but we can get back on the wagon.
Just gonna continue trying different things. I'm gonna add some, a little bit of vegetables in with my meats and just kind of make it more exciting. Today is Friday, July the 14th.
That evil thing.
Day 28, doing a carnivore diet.
424.0 pounds.
Ooh.
Is she on oxygen? Because she's breathing so hard it's giving me anxiety. So she must have some other issue besides just an infection. I don't know very well. I just know that I'm liking that she's making progress.
Now we've reached the end of the 30-day carnivore diet for Miss Candy. She has hopefully learned from this slip-up and gotten right back on track, so I'm excited to see her weigh in and total lost.
Okay, so it's Friday, the 21st of July. Another week down. I totally stayed on track this week. Feeling loads better. I've just got a lot of energy right now.
Bro, that is not the same damn person, right? There's no, like, gray around the eyes. She looks way, like, she feels way better. I'm happy for her, man, because it's hard to watch somebody that's, like, where I was, that just sits there and ignores that there's a problem. So if they're going to address the problem, I'm going to, you know, give them their props. She deserves it.
And, you know, trying to find stuff to do with myself during the day. So I made 2 meals over the last couple of days. Lots of veggies in there, I had some Brussels sprouts, which I had been craving. And I was still under calories yesterday by 300, so go me. So intermittent fasting, basically, OMAD, 1 meal a day, plus calorie deficit. I'm not trying to brag. I'm really not. I'm just...
No, you deserve to brag. Brag all you want. I brag like shit sometimes, but I mean... it's worth it. Like, you're doing good. You deserve to be, you know, people shouldn't be hating on you at all. Like, I joked about you falling off the wagon, all right? but you're definitely still on it because you're doing good.
Very, very proud of myself. It's Friday, July 21st, and I'm about to do my weekly weigh-in.
411.4 pounds.
411.4. Damn.
She's going down, down, down.
Wow, Candy, good for you. Even after a major slip-up last week, she didn't let it discourage her, didn't use it as an excuse to give up, and it paid off.
True.
What an inspiration.
Bro, she beat my best month. Mine was like 35 pounds. So she's definitely on it, man. I'll be the first to admit that I did some lazy stuff along the way, was eating way too much. I wasn't counting no damn calories. I wasn't looking at fat. I was strictly cutting carbs, and I still dropped 35 in a month. Was like my best month. But she was more strict than, you know, like I F up too. Everybody F's up, but she's doing good, man.
And if you're curious what this girl thinks of all of this,
Christ.
Here it is.
And restriction and cutting out certain foods, such as saying, this is bad, I shouldn't eat this, I should just eat some vegetables and some crap. It is a restriction, and that perpetuates the binge cycle. And as you can see...
Oh my god, I like Candy. This one drives me nuts, man. I just picture this woman as like a chocolate fondue fountain of diarrhea from the story I heard that one time about the threesome and the bathroom blowout, man. I can't get it out of my head. I just see brown when I look at this chick, like just straight, ugh.
That guilt, that restriction when you overeat, like, okay, I'm not going to eat this anymore at all. No, it doesn't work that way. That causes a binge. And I hate to use this as an example and target. I'm not targeting, I'm not being rude, but it is public, so I'm allowed to comment on it. You know, a hungry fat chick was doing, she has binge eating disorder too. I know exactly what she's going through. What I don't support is the carnivore diet.
Hater, hater, hater. You don't want to stick to a diet, so you're going to hate on her? Like, why? What's the point, man? Like, just because you're making the big mukbang bucks don't mean that she can't get off the wagon, you know? But, I don't know. Mukbang channel coming soon.
It's super unreasonable. It's counterproductive to binge eating recovery, okay? And that's how I've done that for so many years, too. Every time I eat something like this, I immediately think after, oh my gosh, I did so much wrong today, I might as well go binge out. No, I have to like catch myself and recondition my thinking, you know, getting rid of those food rules, saying, it's fine. I had a few spring rolls. I'm not.
Oh, a few. Good. How much is in there? She's got like fuck half a Red Lobster in that damn thing. But anyways, yeah, I guess some people do just say, screw it. I'm going to go all out because I messed up. But it's just going to make the problem worse, right?
Not, you know, nothing's going to happen. I can have them again in the future. This is not bad food. This is a single portion that I bought. Carnivore diet, diets like that are restrictive, you cannot, with somebody with binge eating, you cannot eat, and I think they can cause binge eating. You think that eating red meat every day with butter on it is healthy, really?
You're cutting carbs. I mean, I don't know about the butter part. I wasn't mixing butter in with everything, but you're cutting carbs. It does work. Your body just processes that food better. I don't know. The carbs turn to sugar in your body, right? I think.
You're removing all pleasure from eating, you know?
Well, I mean, you don't need that damn much pleasure. You'll freaking blow out the bathroom again. But all right, guys. Hungry fat chick, 41 pounds in a month. That's impressive, man. I'm happy for her. And I think eventually it'll even out where the people that support her will come in there and they'll actually support her. Like the people that started out wanting to support Amberlynn Reed, right? Because you'll find that a lot more people want to see you do better than want to watch you crash and burn. Look at you guys. You support me. I'm losing weight. And, I mean, I appreciate the hell out of it. I think she'll get a fan base like that. I don't think she'll be seeing, you know, millions of views anymore, which is going to hurt her pocket. So I see how she's kind of like, oh, well, I'm caught in a catch-22. But she's really ill, guys. So she definitely needs to make that change. She can't just sit there and keep doing mukbangs because it's detrimental to her health. But I support her. Hopefully, maybe she can see this video or something. She's doing great. Just keep it up. The only hole you can't dig yourself out of is the grave. And you got pretty damn close, but you're lucky there was a ladder. But All right, guys. Like, comment, subscribe. I'll see y'all later. Peace.